and today I'm going to make a video on 10 bearded dragon fun facts. I'm sorry, this shirt is a little slippery. So these are 10 bearded dragon fun facts you may or may or not have known. I pretty much researched everything, but there are some things that a lot of bearded dragon care websites or care sheets don't tell you about bearded dragons. I mean, these aren't necessarily for the care of a bearded dragon. It's just like, you know, a little fun fact about their characteristics, whether that is a physical characteristic or their behavior and all that jazz. So let's get into the video. Okay, so the first fun fact I have about bearded dragons is they actually have a third eye. I know. I was just as shocked as you. I mean, I learned this quite a long time ago, but they actually have a third eye. You're probably thinking, well, where is it? There's only two. No, there's one actually right here. I'll put a picture because Fitz is a little antsy. Yes, they have a third eye, also known as the parietal eye. This is used to measure shadow, so that's how they basically see when something's coming from above them. And it's also used to measure light. They use this mainly in the wild when there's prey. So if there's, you know, a bird or something trying to attack them and they're coming from above, then it's easy for them to tell because they have a third eye. Now, I'm pretty sure it's just a shadow, like I guess it's like a little sensor. I don't think they can see through the top of their head, but I'm not sure. If any of you want to actually look more into that, that'd be cool. But they definitely do have a third eye. It also is used to sense heat. So that's mainly how a bearded dragon tells whether they're too hot or not, and whether, you know, the amount of sunlight they're getting is enough or not, because they use that third eye. So if you're ever wondering, what is that small circle on top of my bearded dragon's head? It's an eye. So don't touch it. Another fun fact is that their teeth can actually fall out, but they do grow back. So unlike humans, you know how when we're babies, our first set of teeth come out and then they grow right back. But after that, if you lose a tooth, you're pretty much done. Well, for bearded dragons, their front teeth can actually rip out of their mouth when they're eating prey in the wild. So mainly their front teeth, because they use their back teeth to bite on the vegetables, but their front teeth to like tear up the prey and eat them. So in some cases, their teeth actually may fall out, but it is easy for them to regrow those teeth. So that's another fun fact that I didn't know. Another fun fact is bearded dragons can actually sleep while they're standing. So if you see a lot of your bearded dragons like this, they're asleep. It's just that they can fall asleep while standing. Majority of time when a bearded dragon sleeps, you usually see their head down right beside their hands. But if you see like your bearded dragon is uncomfortable while sleeping, because I know I do, I see Fitz like standing up in his like, you know, standing position, and I see him asleep, I'm like, why don't you just put your head down or something? But no, they can actually lock their limbs in order to sleep standing up. So if you're wondering if they're actually asleep or just resting their eyes, they're probably asleep. So I know most of you have probably seen that bearded dragon video on YouTube where the guy pushes his bearded dragon a little bit and he starts running on his hind legs. Well, yes, that is true. All bearded dragons are capable of running on their hind legs. They do this if there was someone chasing them. So basically, a lot of these facts revolve around the wild factor. So this is mainly what they do in the wild. If there was a predator chasing them, their hind legs, by being on their hind legs, actually allows them to run much faster. So they actually stand up straight and like a human. Okay, so most of you have probably seen your bearded dragon bulge their eyes out, and it can be very scary at some time. So I finally found out, you know, what really is the cause for this whole eye bulging thing. They can eye bulge before shed, which basically it helps to relieve the skin or loosen up the skin so it's easier to shed. It can also mean that your bearded dragon has high blood pressure. And lastly, it can mean that your bearded dragon is yawning. So literally, that's their way of yawning sometimes, is bulging their eyes out. I know it's crazy. I didn't believe it either. Okay, so I know a lot of you probably know this already, but there is a good, you know, amount of people who don't know that the holes on the side of bearded dragons are their ears. I get this question a lot from people in pet stores. I still don't get why they ask me, what lizard is this? Oh, is that a lizard? Hello, you work at a pet store. And they sometimes ask, what are the holes on their ear? I know my family a lot ask that, you know, when they first see Fitz, they're like, why he got holes on the side of his head? They're his ears. And they have great hearing, by the way. Their hearing is excellent. Literally, you see how I have that stand-up container next to Fitz's tank? He can hear the worms like digging, and that's how he knows that they're down there. So that's why I've diagnosed, that's why he glass surfs, because as soon as I take him out, he runs right there and starts jumping on it. Another fun fact is, you know your bearded dragon's eyes are on the side of their head so they can see their tail? another, you know, wild physical feature, they have their eyes on the side of their head, so just in case they were getting chased, or if someone was approaching them from behind and trying to grab their tail, they would be able to see it and able to make a run for it. This next one is really interesting, so prepare yourself. Do you know the bumps on them right here? In the wild, they're used to collect water. Yes, it's true. They collect water in their body with the bumps, you know how they're, you know, concaved up, and in the middle is like the water. And then when they get thirsty, they just have to bend forward, and then all the water goes right through their eyeballs and over their... So this is, my finger is the water. And they literally just... That's how they get their water. That's incredible, right? I did not even know that. But that's a reason why they have the little bumps. Another fun fact is, you know how a bearded dragon's scales or spikes are not really painful? They're kind of rubbery. So as a bearded dragon owner, you know, we already know that these are rubbery, and most of the time, or even all the time, they don't really hurt when we pick them up. You know, they actually do get pretty spiky when they're in defense mode. So when a predator is coming or they feel like they're in danger, they immediately become stiff and it hurts to pick them up, it hurts to eat them. So I feel like bearded dragons have a great defense mechanism in the wild, because who would want to eat some spiky ball? Like, I wouldn't. If I was a lion or something, I wouldn't want to eat him. That's nasty. Do you know the tips of a bearded dragon tongue are sticky? Well, you probably did know that, because you see when they eat, they literally just like go forward a little bit and then like, and it comes to them. It's because the tips of their tongue are very sticky. So it's easier for them to pick up insects or anything, instead of just like us, you know, us grand humans. If we lick something, it just sits there. But if a bearded dragon does, it's like a shing. It's like one of those gummy splat hands when you like throw it and it picks up something. That's how they are. So that's pretty cool. And the last fun fact is, do you know in the wild, a bearded dragon roughly lives for about only 5 to 10 years, whereas if they are domesticated, they live for about 10 to 15 years, and sometimes even longer than that on average. It is because in the wild, it's more easier for them to, I didn't want to say killed, that's such a harsh word, but you get what I mean. When they're domesticated, we ensure that they get the right amount of calcium, the right sunlight, the right UVB, everything they need, whereas in the wild, that some days they may not get the right calcium, some days they may not be able to eat, but we ensure the safety of our lizards. So technically, I believe it's much safer for bearded dragons if they're domesticated. So I think all of us should form a little group, right? And we go out and like just catch all the wild bearded dragons and keep them in one like big bearded dragon sanctuary in like, I don't know, Texas or something, where it's hot. And then we just have everyone come, and like it could be the only place where we could have all those bearded dragons. I think that'd be a great idea. So I hope this video was informational for all of you, and I hope you learned something new about bearded dragons or scale babies. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next video.